We have a very special person here that I...
Well, they've met a few times.
You met him a few times. I believe in him. And he was a two-time mayor of Miami, Miami Beach. Now, I don't know if you understand Miami Beach. It's probably the most difficult city in the world to maintain order and forward-lookingness and, you know, to avoid controversy.
Especially with the Ridingers living there.
I mean, it's a crazy, crazy town. I know every town has some of it. It's just exponential here.
Yes.
So, he was a wonderful mayor. He accomplished a lot of great things. He moved the city forward. What I love about this man is he's not political. He's apolitical. Well, you got to be on one party or the other. And he's an entrepreneur. I like to see entrepreneurs in politics because we got a lot of problems. And the entrepreneurial mind is a solution to those problems. I really believe that. I have a tremendous concern about the division and polarization in this country. It has never been so bad since the Civil War. And we're accomplishing much less than could be accomplished. People want to pick their own issue and even stop their own party from, you know, making some accomplishments. But it's got to the point where it's ridiculous, where you're even afraid to say who you vote for because you might get beat up.
For sure.
That's not what America is about.
Yeah, and by the way, we're not either left or right. We're for the people.
Right.
That's what we're for.
Right. So, as you know, I am conservative economically. I might be a little liberal on social issues, but I'm very conservative economically. You know that, right? But what I really am is make America better, bring people together. Let's not be so divided. We have more in common than we have differences. So let's look for the commonalities and not the differences. And I believe that this guy can do it. So he announced his candidacy for governor in the state of Florida. Now, so goes Florida, so goes the nation, for some reason. It's a very important state, very influential. It has tremendous influence internationally because of the people that come here from Europe and South America. So it's that's what some people know is New York or Miami, and that's their impression. So this guy threw his hat in the ring and took a chance. And I backed him with more money than I've ever given a candidate before because I believe in him and he'll do the right thing and he will decrease bipartisanism, which I would really like to see. I want us to be forward-looking problem solvers, not polarized. So his entrepreneurial way, he's kind of like Jerry Siciliano, a very young one. He has this knack of bringing people together. He listens to everybody. And if they have a problem or a beef, he listens to them, and he kind of does like Dennis. You know, I hear you. I understand. I got it. But, you know, the situation is this, and we're going to have to get through it. Let's not lose sight of the goal. That's it, to make a better world a better place. And he's extremely dedicated and passionate to that. So I'd like to
And I just want to say one thing, too. 20 years ago, Jaron and I became very good friends with Philip. And I think the thing that I want to just mention to you is that 20 years ago, I knew that one day, I know that he's running for governor, but I know that one day Philip Levine will be the president of the United States.
It's nice and to have a friend in the governor.
So I know he's going to say, well, let's get to governor first, but he will. But I will tell you, I've thought about it 20 years before. So the reason why he's here today is because I want to remind him that when he does win the presidency one day, he's going to be back on this stage talking about Market America. Ladies and gentlemen, Philip Levine.
We're not here to pressure you. one way or the other. We wanted to expose this great individual to you. It takes a lot of money to become governor. And we kind of have like a crowdfunding thing. So if you get the feeling that I get, we're going to email out the address that you can send whatever you can send.
Every dollar makes a difference.
But it's not about money. It's about doing the right thing.
No, it's about what I said. So one day, when I told you 20 years ago I knew you would be president one day, when you become president, you have to promise to come back here one day.
I give you that honor and my privilege. I couldn't wait. I look forward to it. 100%. Thank you both so much.
I love you.
Folks, by the way, they call it Market America for a reason. So I can tell you, if God willing, someday we keep rising up, I will be here, and it would be my honor to be with both of you. And I thank you so much for your friendship.
We got that on tape.
You got it on tape, Loren.
But Philip wanted to use powered by people, but we wouldn't let him.
You know, first of all, it's just an honor to be here. And I remember being here the last couple of years, and I think I gave you a key to the city and a proclamation.
Right.
And that, twice. That's right. Fantastic. And there's nothing more impressive to see this many amazing entrepreneurs here in Miami. And of course, we are an entrepreneurial country. We are an entrepreneurial city. So this is fantastic to have all of you here in Miami.
Woo!
We really do. And you know, it's funny, wherever I go around the state of Florida running for governor, I always tell people, I said, listen, I'm not a politician. You know, actually, my background is I started with $500 and a pocket full of dreams, and I built my companies in the cruise ship industry, and thank God I built them, and I sold them, and I decided to give back and become a mayor, and now I want to become governor, as JR said and Loren said, to do the right thing. And I always say, I'm not right, and I'm not left. I'm forward, and that's the direction we need to take our entire country going forward. That, to me, is the most important thing. Because it's people like you that power our nation with your entrepreneurial zeal and your spirit. Loren and JR are a model for the entire state of Florida. They are treasures in Miami Beach. So I can't thank you enough. And you know, I always put my skin in the game. When I decided to run for governor, I wrote my own check and said, I'm going to put in millions, and we've been raising, thank God, an incredible amount of money. But I'd like to ask all of you one favor, just one favor. If you look at this guy here and say, you know what, this guy could do something good for all of us, all I want from you is $1, just $1. And if you would consider going online to philiplevine2018.com, and do $1, that would be something very special to me. So
yeah.
I hope you'll do
Come
it.
On.
$1 would
Woo!
Mean a lot to
Everybody
me
can do
from
that.
Each one of you. Nothing more than that. So thank you so much, and have a wonderful time in Miami. And JR and Loren, always your friendship, your support. You are the ultimate entrepreneurs. You are the American dream. And the Florida dream and the American dream are the same dream we all share together. So thank you so much. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, guys.